I like to show you how to remove useless variables from a context-free grammar. Well, actually, these ones are called non-terminals, but at this moment we are allowed to call the non-terminals variables because it's easier to distinguish the words variables and terminals. So, first I have to show you two examples on how what useless variables are. The first one, let's take this as production rules of another grammar. Maybe we have a start symbol that goes to, well, let's say A. And maybe we have another, only this other rule, C goes to A. And now, as you can see, if you have the start symbol, you can never get to C, and you can never use the C from the start symbol, so you would never have a C when you derived a word from this grammar. So in this case, you have those C as useless variable that you can throw out. So the other case that you can have, maybe you have, well, you have a variable that you can read from the start symbol, so let's say this A. But this variable just goes into a loop. So it will, if there's no other rule here, then you will never find an end when you do a derivation with the A. So in every infinite word, you won't have any A in it because you cannot generate a finite word with this A. So in this case, the A would be useless too, and so this part of the rule. So let's have a look. All we have to do is, well, let's start with the first case. We see if we have variables that we can't read from the start symbol. So we have those S, we can reach the A. If you have a really big grammar, then you may want to write them down. So first you can reach the start symbol, as you can always reach the start symbol. So you can reach the A with this rule, and you can reach the B with this rule. So now let's see what we can reach from A and from B. So from A you can reach E. E is new. B, we already have B in the set. We can reach E as well. From B we can reach D. So D will be new as well. Sorry. D. And, well, we look into the sets of E. From E we can reach A and S, we already have them in the set. And from D we can reach D and B, so D and B are also in the set. So this is a set of the variables that we can reach from the start symbol. And as you can see, C is not there because C doesn't appear on any other right side, but only in the rule form itself. So we can never use the C. So we can just throw the rule out. So let's see. Now we want to see if we have any variables that never lead to a terminate, that will never terminate because they don't, you can't reach any terminal string from them. So we can do them, we can do it backwards. So as you can see, we have a terminal in the rule of E. So if you have any E in the derivation, you can just use this rule and it will terminate because it will turn to a terminate B. So we can say that E will terminate. So now we can look where we don't have any other rules where there are single terminals. So let's see where we have variables from that we know that can turn into terminals. And, well, you can see here in the rule of A, you have B and E. And Because you can derive from this E a single B. That means you could get a terminal string from that rule. So we know that A can terminate as well. So we put, I write the steps from that before the sets. So because of this rule, we know that A can terminate too. So let's see if we can terminate any other variables. Well, as you can see, we have here this, the start symbol, and the start symbol can derive to the A, and we already know that A can terminate. So we know that this, because of this rule, S can terminate as well. So now see if we can find something else for the others. So for B, well, you need to terminate D with this rule, or you need to terminate B with this rule, and we don't have any proofs for that yet. Here for D, you see that whatever you do, D will always contain a rule with another D, so it's not possible to terminate with a D. So, D is useless, so we can take it out. I hope you see it. If you have a D in the derivation and you would use this rule, then you would still have another D. And if you would use this rule, you would still have another D. And it's not possible to get rid of the D in the derivation. So this will never terminate. So we know that D will not terminate. And you see we have a D in this rule. And we can't find a proof that B will terminate, because either B will produce a D from which we know that it will never terminate, or B will just produce another B, and we can't terminate this as well. So B is useless as well. And now from the grammar we have to remove the useless variables, so that are B, C, and D, and well, this set is closed. And what we also want to do is that we want to remove the rules where one of those useless variables is on the right hand side. So as you can see in this S rule, we have a B on the right hand side in this rule. And we know that B is useless, so that it will never terminate. So we don't want to use this rule ever, so we can take it out. The same for those A rule, because you have a B that will never terminate in this rule. Well, here you have E and S, they are okay. And, well, that's... that was all. Maybe you have the case that you could have, for example, let's say you had a rule F that goes to, well, that goes to BA, or that goes to CD, or that goes to, I don't know, that only has rules with right-hand side where useless variables are, and you would take out all the rules, and those F would be useless as well, and you had to take it out as well. So we could leave it like this, or we could write those grammar anew to say that these are the, that we only want to this variables in it. But I think it's enough, and I hope you understood.